हेलो, वेलकम टू टुडेज वीडियो ऑन विटामिन ए। विटामिन्स आर ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड्स। दे आर रिक्वायर्ड इन स्मॉल अमाउंट इन द डाइट टू परफॉर्म सर्टन बायोलॉजिकल फंक्शंस। अ बायोकेमिस्ट नेम्ड एज फंक आइसोलेटेड एन अमाइन इन राइस पॉलिशिंग एज वेल एज यीस्ट। ही फाउंड आउट दैट दिस अमाइन विच वॉज एन एक्टिव प्रिंसिपल इन देम कुड क्योर बेरी बेरी इन पिजन्स। He named them as vitamin, and it was later found out that not all of the vitamins have amine in them. The use of alphabets such as A, B, and C to vitamins was assigned by a biochemist named McCollum and Davis. Vitamins are broadly classified based on their solubility. So, first is water soluble and fat soluble. In fat soluble, we have vitamin A, D, E, and K, while in water soluble, there is vitamin B and vitamin C. In vitamin B, there are again further classifications. So, together they are called as B complex, and vitamin C is called as the non-B complex. The food which is from the animal source usually has vitamin A, while in case of plants, the provitamins, that is carotenes, are obtained. Provitamins are the substances which get converted into vitamin in the body of an organism. Retinoids, this term indicates the natural and synthetic form of vitamin A. Vitamers, these are the substances which are chemically similar to vitamin, so they will be having similar activity. Some of the vitamers of vitamin A are retinol, retinal, and retinoic acid. Let's discuss each of them. The first one is retinol. Here OL means it will be having an alcohol group. It is also called as vitamin A alcohol. There is a ring present here which is called as beta-ionin ring. It is having two isoprenoid units. So this will be the first isoprenoid unit and the second one. And there are four double bonds in retinol. In animals, this retinol is stored in the tissues in the form of retinyl esters along with the long chain fatty acids. The second vitamer is retinal or retinaldehyde, which is vitamin A aldehyde. This retinal is obtained by oxidation of retinol, that is vitamin A alcohol. So, the vitamin A alcohol and vitamin A aldehyde are interconvertible. Initially, the retinaldehyde was also called as retinine. Retinoic acid is the next vitamer of vitamin A. It is obtained when retinaldehyde or retinal will undergo oxidation. But retinoic acid is not interconvertible to retinal or retinol back. Beta carotene, which is the pro vitamin, this usually in the intestine will form two moles of retinal. In the humans, this conversion, that is beta carotene to retinal, that is two moles of retinal, is insufficient. Therefore, beta carotene will be having 1/6 vitamin A activity in comparison to the retinol. These are some of the sources from where we can get vitamin A. The biochemical functions of vitamin A. First one, retinol and retinoic acid. It is used for cell growth and differentiation, for synthesis of glycoprotein and mucopolysaccharides, also helpful in functioning of immune system and regulating the gene expression because it will act like an hormone. It was seen that the animals who are deficient in vitamin A were used for the discovery of coenzyme Q. This coenzyme Q is an antioxidant present in the body. So if an animal is deficient in vitamin A, this coenzyme Q will be produced. For this production, mevalonate is used. This mevalonate is an intermediate in the cholesterol biosynthesis. Functions of beta carotene involve antioxidants, therefore it can prevent the heart attack. And comparison to vitamin A, this beta carotene high dose is less toxic. George Wald explained how vitamin A will be useful for the process of vision. So there is a cycle called as rhodopsin cycle or Wald's visual. In human eye, there are rods as well as cones. Rods will be useful for the dim light and cones are useful for vision in the bright light. So rhodopsin is a conjugated protein and it is present in rods. It is also called as 11-cis retinal opsin. There is isomerization of this 11-cis retinal to all trans retinal. So cis forms the trans form, and this isomerization is responsible for the nerve impulse. There is a conformation change in the opsin. This all happens because the light or the photon fall on this rhodopsin. All trans retinal must immediately get isomerized to all cis retinal so that it can again combine with opsin and form rhodopsin back. The enzyme involved in this conversion is retinal isomerase. At times, all trans retinal is not entirely converted to the cis form. So, this will enter the liver, and in liver, the enzyme called alcohol dehydrogenase will form all trans retinol. Means the aldehyde form, the AL form, gets converted to the alcohol form, the retinol, OL form. All trans retinol in the liver is converted to 11-cis retinol by the enzyme isomerase. This can immediately get oxidized to the 11-cis retinal, that is, alcohol is getting converted to retinal. Finally, we want 11-cis retinal again because it is going to combine with opsin, which is the protein, and regenerate rhodopsin. This is what is explained by George Wald. There is a term which is called as dark adaptation time, which means that once from bright light an individual enters into a very dark light, dim light area, it takes time for the eyes to adjust. After a few minutes, we can get adapted to the dark light. This is because the rhodopsin is resynthesized. In individuals where vitamin A is deficient, there is increase in the dark adaptation time, which means they take more time to adapt to the darkness. In presence of light, this rhodopsin, which is red in color, gets converted to yellow color. This process is called as bleaching of rhodopsin. It occurs in few milliseconds, and during this process, many intermediates are being formed and they are unstable. They involve rhodopsin, which forms pre-lumirhodopsin, lumirhodopsin, metarhodopsin 1, metarhodopsin 2, and finally we have this all-trans retinal and opsin, which are available, and they enter the Wald's cycle again. The usual cassette and the cGMP. This cycle is useful for hyperpolarization of the membrane present in the rods so that the nerve impulse can be generated into the nerves which are present in the eye, and the message can be sent to the visual cortex of the brain. For this, rhodopsin once forms metarhodopsin 2 in the bleaching cycle. This metarhodopsin 2 is useful to activate a protein which is transducin. Once this protein is activated, it can again activate another enzyme which is phosphodiesterase. This phosphodiesterase enzyme will degrade the cyclic GMP, which is also called as the cGMP, in the rod cells. Once the cGMP decreases, it will close the sodium channels in the rods, because of which there is hyperpolarization and there is excitatory response. So so that this can transmit from the neurons in the eye to the visual cortex in the brain. Absorption, transport and mobilization of vitamin A. So whatever vitamin A is consumed in the diet is either beta carotene or retinyl esters. So beta carotene is present from the plants, which will easily enter the intestine cell, and in the cell it will form retinal, that is aldehyde form of vitamin A. This is the enzyme which is involved in this conversion. This retinal will again get converted to retinol, the alcohol form, while the retinyl esters are broken down to retinol and the free fatty acid. The enzyme involved in this conversion is hydrolase. This hydrolase is available from pancreas or the intestinal brush border. So finally we have retinol back from beta carotene as well as the retinyl esters. This retinol in the intestinal cell will combine with the free fatty acid to form retinyl esters. These retinyl esters then will get incorporated into chylomicron. Chylomicrons are the lipoproteins which are useful for transport of lipids. So they will transfer this retinyl esters to lymph and then to the liver. In the liver, finally, it is stored in the form of retinyl palmitate. So, vitamin A is stored in the form of retinyl palmitate. And as and when it is needed, it will be released. So, it is either used by the eye, that is retina, for the visual cycle. So, whatever form is stored in the liver is released. The second use of this retinol is for the gene expression and which is useful for transcription. Transcription is a process where the DNA will be forming the mRNA. For more details regarding the transcription, I suggest you all to refer the video on transcription under the nucleic acid topic. So coming back, we have this retinol which will combine with the retinol binding protein, and this complex is useful and is recognized by the target cell. So once it reaches the cell, the retinol enters the cell, gets converted to retinoic acid, will be useful for the transcription process, and finally the protein whichever is needed is synthesized. So this is how we have absorption, the transport and the mobilization of vitamin A. In case of color vision, there are three pigments and they are color sensitive. They involve porphyropsin, which is red, iodopsin green, and cyanopsin blue. These three are responsible for the color vision. They are retinal opsin complexes, and when the light will be falling on the retina, based on the color of the light, these three pigments are split, or in simple words, they are bleached. So these three pigments will be split into different proportions, and based on this different proportion, the brain can perceive the different colors. Vitamin A deficiency could either be due to the decrease in the intake of this vitamin A in the diet by the individuals, or there is impairment in absorption from intestine. The third reason could be chronic alcoholism or reduction in the storage of this vitamin A in the liver. It usually takes 2 to 4 months for the symptoms to be manifested. The following are the different deficiency symptoms. The first one is night blindness or nyctalopia. In night blindness, the individual takes time to adapt into the dim light because there is increase in the dark adaptation time. This night blindness causes an irreversible damage to the cells present in the eye. Second deficiency symptom is xerophthalmia. It involves dryness in the conjunctiva and the cornea. Along with dryness, there is keratinization of the epithelial cells. Next deficiency symptom is the Bytot's spots. In this, the triangular plaque will be developed. This is because of excessive drying of the conjunctiva. Keratomalacia. It is a deficiency symptom where corneal ulceration and degeneration would occur, because of which there is total destruction of cornea, and if this occurs, there is total blindness. This keratomalacia is usually because xerophthalmia is for long time. Other deficiency symptoms could be growth retardation, because vitamin A plays an important role in helping the growth of an organism. Next is sterility in the males, and it could be because the reproductive system is affected and the germinal epithelium is degenerated. There is also bacterial infection and urinary stones, because there is keratinization of the epithelial cells in the GIT tract, urinary tract and respiratory tract. Hypervitaminosis A. It is a condition where there is toxicity due to the excessive consumption of vitamin A. The following are the symptoms of it. Elderly patients are more susceptible to this toxicity. The total serum vitamin A level must be 20 to 50 microgram per deciliter. If this level is elevated, we call it as hypervitaminosis A. One must ensure that free retinol or retinol which is bound to the plasma lipoprotein must not exist in the body, because it increases the synthesis of the lysosomal hydrolase enzyme. This enzyme causes the destructive action on the cell membrane. The daily requirement of vitamin A is expressed in terms of retinol equivalence and not as international units. So when we say one retinol equivalent, it means 1 microgram of retinol or 6 microgram of beta carotene and so on. So these are the units how vitamin A will be expressed, and 1 international unit means 0.3 mg of retinol. But we have to note that it will be expressed in terms of retinol equivalence only and not as international units. So RDA, which is the recommended dietary allowance of vitamin A for adult male, is 1000 retinol equivalents, and for an adult female it is 800 retinol equivalents. This recommended dietary allowance usually increases for pregnant women and lactating mothers. So here we come to an end of vitamin A. In the next video we will be learning about vitamin D. Thank you.